Hello friends, here in this video we will see what is meant by variable stresses. Now, to understand variable stresses, first I'll write down when a material is subjected to only one value of stress of same nature, then it is called as static stress. That is, when we are having a material which is loaded with only one value of stress and having the same nature, that is, if the stress is tensile, it will remain tensile throughout. If it is compressive, it will remain compressive throughout with the same value. So that is called as static stress, that is one value of stress and only one nature. Next, when a material is subjected to more than one value of stress and may have same or opposite nature, then it is called as variable stress. So here I have written the definition of variable stress, that when a material is subjected to more than one value of stress and that stress may be of same nature or it can be of opposite nature. Like for example, if we have this pin, then if we are applying tensile load over this pin, then there will be tensile stress. If I go on changing the value of load, that will result in different values of tensile stress, and that is an example of variable stress because the stress value goes on changing. Similarly, if I am applying over this pen, at one time there is tensile load and at the other time if there is compression, there is compressive load, so the nature of stress changes. So when a material is subjected to stress of same kind but of different values, or stresses of two different kinds, then it is called as variable stress. Now to understand this, I'll take an example. Example of variable stresses. Now here, let us consider a shaft, circular in section. Now this shaft, if it is placed along the length, in this way. Now if this shaft is supported at its two extreme ends, now on this shaft I am considering point A at the top, point B is at the bottom. Now let us say that there is a load acting at the center of this shaft, which is having length capital L. So now, as this is a shaft is a rotating member, so this will start rotating with some speed. And now when the shaft is rotating, at the same time we are keeping a load on the shaft. So what will happen is the shaft will try to bend because of this load. It will bend in this way. Now, as we can see, point A is at the top. So when the shaft bends, at the top there is compression and at the bottom there is tension. So now when point A is at the top, it is subjected to compression, point B is subjected to tension. Now, when the shaft has rotated, if point B occupies the position of A, then B will be subjected to compression and A will be subjected to tension. In the next cycle, when again point A reaches up, it will be subjected to compression and B will be subjected to tension. So, like this, this cycle goes on and on. So, therefore, we can say that, therefore, the shaft is subjected to two kinds of stresses, that is tensile stress and compressive stress, which are repeating successively. Therefore, such stresses are called cyclic stresses. So, when the shaft is subjected to two different kinds of stresses, and if the value remains same, then also it is called as variable stress, or here in this case it is called as cyclic stress. Now, even if the value of stress changes, then also it is an example of variable stresses. So, in this video, we have seen what is meant by variable stresses.